When I started on my journey, a friend said that I should visit an alternative community out on the Llyn Peninsula, near my home in North Wales. Apparently, they have a solution to the age-old problem of dealing with waste that is safe, odour-free, and doesn't use any water.
Oh, this is my.
You're welcome to the Velinach Health Centre.
Thank you very much indeed.
Our compost toilet.
Well, how does it work?
Well, come in and have a look.
Okay. Right, but it looks quite ordinary.
All the elements you'd expect to find in a conventional public toilet are here. How it works is that when you lift it, you'll notice that it doesn't have the flush, right. It just has a hole down to the concrete chamber beneath us. It doesn't smell, no.
No.
Because so it's dry compost that's down there, and compost because it's sewage mixed with a dry material like this sawdust here.
So that's your flush in a way.
So that's the flush. So you'd add a handful of that every time you used it.
Okay.
That sort of soaks up any of the moisture and helps the composting.
Broken
and up. It's ripe for taking up and taking onto the garden. Well rotted should be by now. We'll find out, shall we?
Come on then.
Right.
Get the spade.
My journey has taken me all around the world in search of the perfect toilet and helped me understand that the way we deal with our excrement shapes who we are. But after travelling all that way, I'm back where I started, in rural Wales, sprinkling a handful of dust on my business. It seems my uncle and aunt were onto something all along. This really doesn't smell, and there are no flies. I'm very glad I don't have to use a hanging toilet in the slums of Dhaka. I'd love to have a Japanese toilet with heated seats and built-in cleaning system. And I look forward to the day my loo creates instant energy for my home. But until then, I quite like the honesty of taking a barrel load of well-rotted shit to spread around the base of a tree, completing that age-old cycle of dung to life.